In this video, we're going to be taking a look at essentially what is statistics as a practice. What exactly is it that we do when we engage in the practice of statistics? So a couple of things, just as background. Statistical methods help us examine information and make decisions when faced with uncertainties. Okay, they help us to examine information and make decisions when faced with uncertainties, which is one of the reasons that statistics tends to be very applicable to circumstances that you'll run into in everyday life. If we're looking at the other thing that we'll typically be doing with statistical methods is that they also enable us to look at information from a small collection of people or items and make inferences about a larger collection of people or items. So those are basically the two main times that we would want to use statistical methods. If we need to make decisions and we have incomplete information or there's some uncertainty in the decision, statistical methods can help us analyze that information to help us make those decisions. Also, if we want to move from a small collection to, or a sample, in other words, to make inferences or figure out or estimate information about a larger collection of people or items, then statistical methods can help us do that as well. And we'll be looking at the different processes here basically throughout the rest of the quarter. Now, the practice of statistics, when you're doing either one of these things, is generally speaking made up of four steps. And the four steps are collecting data, organizing data, analyzing data, and interpreting data. Right? These are the four main things that we do when we engage in the process of statistics. For the most part this quarter, we're going to be working with data that's already been collected. We will talk about data collection techniques, and we will get a couple of opportunities throughout the class to actually collect some data ourselves. But for the most part, we're going to be working with data that's already collected, and we will be either organizing it into, you know, charts, graphs, tables. We'll be maybe analyzing it to determine summary statistics or to make inferences or to do hypothesis tests. And then the results of those we will then interpret to figure out what they're telling us in terms of what decisions we should make or what valid estimates are. Okay, so this is essentially what we're going to be doing for the entire course. Now you'll notice that these four steps all have something in common, right? They all involve data. Data is the bread and butter of statistics. It's the thing that we work with all the time. And there are several different ways of classifying data. And basically what we're going to look at in the rest of this video is just some terms and definitions that'll be important for you to know when you're talking about data. One of the first things that you should probably know is the distinction between individuals and variables. These terms are used in statistics a little bit differently than they're used in either everyday speech or than they may have been used in your previous math courses. When we talk about individuals in a statistical context, we're not necessarily talking about people. Normally, when we use the word individuals in everyday speech, we're talking specifically about people. But in statistics, individuals are the people or objects included in a study. Okay, so they could be people, if that happens to be the thing that we are studying, or they could be cars, they could be bacteria, they could be medications, they could be, patient records, any kind of thing that we're actually studying or we are including in the study, those are the individuals. Now, variables, by contrast, again, used a little bit differently in statistics, rather than in, say, an algebra course where a variable is just a letter that stands for an unknown number. In statistics, variables are characteristics of the individual that are to be measured or observed. Okay, so that's the difference between individuals and variables. Individuals are the people or objects that we include, and variables are actually the things that we measure or observe about those people or objects. So this is essentially the who, and this is the what, if you want to think of it in that context. So let me give you an example. Let's say that we are working for a car company, and we're going to do some market research. So we're going to collect a bunch of information about a bunch of different cars. So the individuals would be the cars, right? That's what we're including in the study. We are going to observe or record information about different types of cars. Now the variables are not the cars themselves, they're the things that we might be measuring about the cars. So if we wanted to do some market research to figure out the kinds of things that people typically look for when they're trying to determine a car to buy, there are a bunch of different variables that we could measure. We could measure price, we could measure maybe the color, and this would be more observed rather than measured, but price, color, make, model, year, engine type, transmission, right? Is it an automatic or is it a manual? Size. Okay, all of these kinds of things. This would be the information that we would be either observing or measuring or recording about the cars that we included in our study. So again, this is the who did we include in the study? That's the individuals. This is the what did we actually measure or record in the study. And the what are the variables, the who is the individuals. In the next video, we're going to take a look at some more terminology dealing with different types of variables.